We're gonna check back in with Ethan. It's been a busy week. Ethan, welcome aboard.
Thank you.
And it's your first weekend, right?
Yeah, this is my first weekend. I'm thrown right into it. We've had severe coverage from this past Sunday. We've had a lot of filling in, but that's central Indiana weather in a nutshell. But I'm glad to be here to give you guys the latest weather info. Let's talk about what we have going on now. Today started off dry, but then we had a little bit of rain move through earlier. Time caps out at Victory Field. Luckily, though, that rain was perfect to get out of here before today's Savannah Bananas game. And we are going to be talking about more rain here, as the latest imagery does show a few towering clouds that are going to be coming here. We are quiet for the time being on live Guardian radar, but different story can be said to our south and west. Just in from the National Weather Service is what you're seeing right now. Lots of lightning, a few severe thunderstorm warnings that are currently going on in central Illinois. That's going to get here over the next hour, hour and a half or so, and they are calling this an organized mesoscale convective system, similar to what we had the other day here, although not as defined, with very much a damaging wind threat that's going to be getting here quite shortly. That is why a severe thunderstorm watch has been issued for a majority of our viewing area, basically places Muncie, Noblesville on south, including here in Indy. This goes until 11 o'clock for those storms that are out in Illinois. This goes right in line with the Storm Prediction Center's latest outlook. For us here in Indy, we are under that level 2 slight risk for severe weather, and as forecast still, that level 3 enhanced risk for severe weather is in place down to our south. That does include spots like Bloomington to our south. In terms of severe risk, that pretty much goes in line here. It is a lower tornado risk, although a slightly higher one to our south. Large hail is possible throughout our viewing area. Again, a little bit higher to our south. And you see this hatched area here too. Once again, going to be a wind-driven event with gusts up to 70 miles per hour that already have been reported with these storms in central Illinois. And that's going to be coming here over the next couple of hours. Let's time it now on Future View. Here's 8:30. I think Future View has this a little late. I think all of this organized activity that's saying right around I-70, I think that's going to get here closer to 7:30, 8 o'clock, and then move through here rather quickly. These storms are moving around 40 to 45 miles an hour, getting out of here probably before our evening newscast come back on later tonight. Then we're going to be talking about more storm chances for your Sunday, although not as defined as today. Here's Sunday, 2 o'clock, going to be kind of like today in terms of timing. Again, the afternoon and early evening, but nothing even close to being as organized as to what we're seeing today. Tomorrow does come with an outlook. Luckily, the severe risk has gone down compared to the last couple of days for Sunday. The closest severe risk is the far southern portions of our area, where a level 1 marginal risk is in play, and then a higher risk even further south and east, but can't rule out a general thunderstorm or two throughout tomorrow afternoon. But right now is that time to prepare before those storms move in here early. Be here again around that 7:30, 8 o'clock time frame, and then get out of here before 10:30. 71 degrees otherwise for that overnight low. Some of those storms will be severe. Southwest wind 10 to 13 miles an hour, but some isolated gusts up to 60, perhaps 70 miles an hour will be associated with these storms. And even more rain chances in my 7 day, although the best day, luckily, does look like July 4th, forecast high of 87 with only a very minuscule rain chance there. And then our next cold front into next week is going to bring us more in the way of storms by Wednesday into Thursday, and it's going to drop our temperatures too. Temperatures getting back into the lower 80s with